All right, someone. I've done a bunch of work since, well, since the video today and the one before it. Let me just start showing you what I did. Basically, I've, as you can see, sealed off all the rooms. I've got to cut the holes, and then I'll do that, and then I can show you how to do it. Well, one way to do it. I don't know if it's the way to do it. Let's get rid of the skin off that module so it matches. In fact, you know what? Let's just do that now. We'll deal with this room, far left-hand corner, nice and neat. Gonna go to, what grid are we at? Four. I'm gonna slice it so it's inside the model. There we go. Hang on, I need to do something. All of my caulk stuff is below the bloody floor line, and the OCD in me won't let that lie. So let me just move shit up. Well, in between my mapping exploits, I've been watching, don't know if any of you lot have been watching it on Netflix, Designated Survivor. Not bad. Then I was always a sucker for anything with Kiefer Sutherland in it because he's such a good actor. Bit old now, but hey, still got his chops. His acting chops, I should say. Come on. Right, let's hide these. I don't know what the, oh, I know what those are. They're for the part of the stairs, which you'll see when you get the map back. Just the OCD in me want to have models poking up through bits of wood with no caps on them, because you wouldn't have that in real life. Yeah, welcome to my world. Little annoying things like this. Right, let's start again, shall we? Right, where were we? Oh yeah, we've got to cut a hole in the master bedroom, which we did. So there you can see, in fact, I've cut that one in the wrong place. Bollocks. There, just inside. In fact, I cut them at, I tried to cut them at grids. In fact, I've said this to Milan a few times, and he's basically, he does it now, even though his artistic flair doesn't lend well to snapping things to grid, which is fine. I would rather he create something that looks beautiful and fantastic, and then I go in and clean it up afterwards, than him to get bogged down by the minutiae I get bogged down with. So little things like this. If I'm working with a mapper who has flair like Milan, like Bal, like who else have I worked with? Few people that don't get bogged down with this kind of stuff, but it just, the reason I'm bogged down with it, I suppose, if we need to come up with an answer as to why Biker Dude gets bogged down with this kind of crap, is it's in my mind, it's good working practice, best working practices, in fact. When you build stuff, you start, like I always build rooms at grid 8. Where are we? That one there. My rooms, they're either one square thick or they're two squares thick. So in this instance, Spring Hill's modules, whether he intended to or not, adhere to my the way I started building maps. You know, when I the first map that I ever made was Business as Usual. I think I the first map was very basic, the second map way better, but still retained the same original basic structure, and then version 3 was just adding some bling to it. And someone will correct me if I'm wrong. I think, I mean, I tried to get out of habit because Milan berates me for games like, look, don't try and fix an old map, use what you think you want to do and do that with a new map, hence this thing with your map. So here we are. But yeah, Best working practices. That's the simple way to look at this. So there I just select the map, go down to the next grid down, which is 4, and then I clip it just above the model. And then the benefit of this, doing it that way, oh, that's something else I should probably mention. As I do side to side, like you just saw me doing, then I clip the bit, and then it makes a perfect brush to make a viz portal. Right click, make viz portal, which I think was your problem when in I mentioned in your map, your original map. So there's a simple way to make viz portals, nice and simple. I won't bore you with, I'm not going to waste time in this video recording that, because that's real simple. I've already started placing a couple of viz portals, but let me hide the entities again. Look, you can see now all the rooms are boxed off. Oh, on a different note, by the way, if you want to, I'm happy to try and do this for you, but it just come up, it's just like it's crying out for it. There's a module, not an L shape, but basically a door, that one there, in fact, that's missing. You know, it's got a space. That, basically, if I put that module there, and obviously just another normal one, the normal single non-L shaped on that bit there, you could put I could build you a secret door, and I'd line up all the textures, etc., so that when you open it, so that the boss, I don't know, could hide some loot in here. This would become his little safe room. We could put a little safe and stuff in here if you wanted to. Just crying out for a secret room, that's what that is. I even tweaked the position of the chair slightly. Look, canted it towards the left, so he can get out of his chair, flick a switch under his desk, or we could mount a little switch down here, or just underneath there, or something. He flicks it and that door opens, and then he can go into that secret room. It's there, the empty space is there, the modules are there for you to do it. All you have to do to make it believable is obviously you're going to have to make a door that fits into that hole perfectly. Would say, I don't know, a grid 0.25 minimum gap. I'd say minimum and maximum gap, because you don't want the gap so big that it's obvious when the player walks into the room. So you want to make it small enough that when you get up close you go, fuck me, that must be a secret door. Now I can do this because I've already done it for Elixir. So I've already got a safe door, so I could just plonk that whole section of wall that I've created for Elixir right there. So let me know if you want that. There's no point in me doing it if you're not going to want it, because then it just goes to waste, etc. Right. What else do I need to show you? Place some lights in the inside the room. Place the lights in the hallway. And I don't know who said this. It was probably Springhill. But placing lights so you've got pools of light. So there's one there, one there, one there. And it zigzags as you go down the hall. Oh, there should be one there, but I think I copied it. I thought I copied it and moved it down to the ground floor. But there'd basically be another one of those there. So basically, as you go down that hole, pool of light there, 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 pool of light there. So it basically gives the thief places to hide. Now, ironically, I haven't done that intentionally, but I think I did it unconsciously, because I know what I like in a thief mission. I've been playing the things for over 10 years, and I just like that, being able to hide, to give you that little bit of, oh shit, there's a guy coming down the hallway, where I'm in a pit, I can dart over there before he sees me into that dark spot, and I've got a 50-50 chance of me avoiding his patrol route, that sort of thing. Does that, I obviously look at stuff in real life. And the other thing you'll probably notice is that I've put a little dirt decal. You won't see it here. In fact, let me just move that out a smidge, because for some reason it's hiding it. Hang on, am I hiding decals? No, I'm hiding patches, I'm an idiot. Right, hang on, let's just make sure this isn't clipping through the wall. There we go. You've got a bit of a dirt decal. Now, you can sort of notice it here, but you'll really notice it in game. And because I'm all about the symmetry, I move these things around. I get them where I want them in the four directions. Oh, another top tip. when you have a lamp in each of the four directions, so left, right, top and bottom, all you need to do is, now with the new grouping feature, again, thank you Grebo for doing that, it's fucking amazing. I can just group that patch and the module, the light entity I want, and I can just spin it around and attach it where I want. Now you do get a tiny bit of vert drift with that. So the way around that is there, look, there's the top one, there's the bottom one, there's the left one, and there'll be a right one around here somewhere. Oh, maybe there isn't one on this. There isn't a right one on this. Oh, there you go, and there's the right one. Job done. So you just basically you think, oh, I need one for a left floor, left wall. Then you clone the left one from this floor, drag it down to the next level, which is what I'm about to do shortly. But before I do that, I thought I'd show you what I did with the dining room. So basically, I started with two arches, didn't like what I had to do. Then I realized I could use existing pillars, basically two of the obtuse corners, to make a half pillar. Happy days. And it all blends in seamlessly. The only thing I had to do was that module, as you can see, it's off by exactly one division at grid one. Because you snap it to the next one along, it pokes out through the module. So the thing to do is just move it in, and then you can get away with that. And I've built my little... what have I done here? Yeah. Oh. I've put a brush there that fills in the gap along the between the edge of that model. There's the brush. There's the new thing that I built. And I think it looks reasonably well. The only issue is the wallpaper on these Notes of Spring Hill, the wallpaper scale on the pillars, the obtuse corners and the full pillars is at a different scale to the rest of the models. See, there it matches, but on the obtuse corners it doesn't. And if he's not watching the video, I think I'll probably have to file a bug tracker. In fact, you know what, let me do that now. Because I keep moaning about these things and I'm not filing bug trackers for them. Right, so. Obtuse, you know what? Let's get a copy of the model number, model name even. Texture scale doesn't match other models. Other interior models. Is that each ball interior? Well, it'll do for now. And now I'm going to save this as to be done. TBDs. Bug trackers. Bug. To be done. Happy days. Come on. Oh, fucking Windows. Thank you. Right, so back to the room. You can see you saw me create this desk. So it's a six place, and I've added two desks on the end. I don't know where I'm going to put the boss's table. Up here, I guess. We could probably change that chair. As it is, I've grouped all of these things. It makes moving them around easier. That's a normal desk, and I've shrunk it down, and I'll have to do the old no draw brush on it because I've shrunk it from front to back. It's thinner that way than it is that way. And it's that technique that you've seen me use a few times already. All right, I'm going to put some wood for the legs. Looks like I'm going to have to go down to the next grid. Yeah, unfortunately, I don't like doing this, but thankfully, the only time I have to do it is for models. Do is then make that thing non-solid. Done. Oh, fucking hell. I'll probably have to move this up a smidge. Yep. A very small smidge. There we go. Grand. Now, if I could be bothered, I'd create another version of that table as well, but no. That's not going to happen today. I've moved a bunch of your stuff that was in the VIP quarters as we're merging the two rooms. I've just cloned them and rotated them. I think we should put different food there. I can steal some stuff that Dram, probably you don't even know who that is, but he's an amazing mapper. He actually works for, he left the mod and worked for, got employed by, I don't know which gaming software developer, but the guy was producing stuff 10 times better than this before anyone in the mod. When the rest of us were all flipping kindergarten map creating, this bloke was creating AA treble stuff. Amazing. Anyway, the point I was going to get to was that he's paid a massive long table with loads of food on it. So I'll steal a bunch of those and slap it on here for you. Part of the VIP room now starts there. So people can retire from the desk there and sit and have a chat and a smoke and whatever. And then we have the smoking room, I suppose. Smoking room? Yeah, go with that. So with its own little fireplace, I'm going to put something there in the corner. I had to remove, there was two bookcases there, but I had to remove the one there because the light is there. So I'm thinking, you know what, let's do this. This model never gets used often enough. I think it's decorative. Yeah, globe, there, nope, globe, nope, I want the globe and the frame, fine, so let's place the globe, we'll snap it to grid 4, in fact it doesn't want to go, and then floor it, then let's create the globe, why is there two different skins, oh, celestial. Interesting. Someone, you can change this if you want to. I don't know what the boss is. If he's a pirate or an ex-pirate, then he'd want... I don't know what he'd want. He'd want one or the other, I guess. Well, we'll stick it there for now. You know, if you want to change it, by all means. But anyway, I think this is a good little addition. Created the arch with the same veneer as on the... I don't know what you call this bit. It's not a skirting board. It's called a... There's a name for that. I can't think of it. Ceiling board, I'm sure that's not the right name. Anyway, there you go. So I think I successfully managed to merge those two rooms, and that took some jiggery pokery. As you can see, the gap now between all the walls is back to grid 8. Even with my obtuse corners, I was getting it all, and I wanted it all to line up because the OCD in me wouldn't let it. And it, like I say, good work in practice. The module, I want to prove to the point, because I think I said this at the beginning of the video series, not many people have built maps with these, so I probably don't have an idea of what's possible, what isn't possible. And I didn't even know about the obtuse corner thing until I tried it in this map, which is just, to put it bluntly, fucking amazing. Oh, I think I need to change the skin on that. Oh no, in this case, remove it. There we go. What have I done with the toilet? Because this is a guest toilet stroke bathroom, I've added a little bit of bling to it, like the seat that I created for the master bathroom, but changed the wood from redwood to walnut. I've still got to fix some of the textures on this bathtub, but made that a little bit more hospitable and give it a little bit of privacy to people there. There'll be obviously a door on that. Put a little fireplace in there. Put a fireplace, a little furnace in both the guest bedrooms. What else? I think there's nothing else that you haven't seen up here already. Right, so let's hide the first floor. And go to the ground floor. Oh, then there's the... Let's move. I've started creating the first layout of stuff directly below the pantry that's going to form the beginnings of the basement. Put a chandelier, used your style, the model you used for one of these rooms in here, because it's the perfect height. Put a little oil lantern in here for the pantry, because this is going to be darkish, because one of these windows, have to figure out which ones I build the outside, which is going to become an opener. What else? Put the fancy. It's not a toilet. What the hell is it? There's a proper name for it. Can't think of the name anyway. I'm done a bottle of wine this evening, so my memory is going, and I'm getting tired. So anyway, put it in there because guest bathroom, people gambling in here. Right, I've changed. I've gone. Your original square tables won't fit in this room. They're too big, and I was going to place that table in here. But you know what? I think I'm going to build. Now I have a choice. I can do both. But if we do both, it's going to kind of. It'll max out the space in this room. And what I'm thinking, the space you've got there is good at the moment. I've made enough space that the player and AI can walk around these tables unimpeded. Although maybe not through here. What I might have to do is move that chair up a little bit. Change this whole thing, this fireplace stuff here to no clip. In fact, let's ungroup. That one there. So let's do that now because sticky outy things always cause a problem when the player wants to crawl over them. So if I do that, that's enough that the player can walk over it if need be, or hide on top of it even when a guard walks past. Right. Anyway, so back to the center table. I can either custom build a proper card playing table. But what I was thinking to add some bling to this, unfortunately I'm going to have to dig up some textures, is a roulette table. So a functioning, I don't know what you call the round thing that spins round. The roulette, I guess. But I'll need some textures, obviously, for the roulette itself and for the table itself. So a bunch of numbers. I don't know what roulette numbers go up to. Let's have a look. Let's see if I can spell roulette numbers. There we go. So, is that 35? Is that as high as it goes? Right. So basically, red back. So, in fact, is that picture? I could use that. Let's see if that's what's the name? Hang on. There we go. I can answer my own question. Roulette numbers image. Creative Commons. It'd be great if I could find a bloody model, but I'm happy to create one. Roulette table stock images. No, we don't want shutter stock. Thank you. No, Commons. Jesus. There we go. What the hell is Wikipedia Commons? No, we want Creative Commons. That one looks good. That's free JPEG. Is that what I think it is? Alright, well, let's go for that for now. If it isn't, I can always pick a different one. I'm going to save it in. Well, you haven't got a textures folder. Right, so. I'm going to guess that this texture, this whole roulette wheel, probably going to be a prop. Oh, come on, Windows 7. Christ! Dark mod. And then. Hang on, let me check this out because I always forget where the props are stored. So, textures, dark mod. They're not stored here. They're still props are stored under models, aren't they? So, where is it? Models, dark mode. All right, okay. Let me open up another. Where are we? Yes, I'd like to. Really? Oh, I already have a models folder because of the dining table. Woo! Right, so props, there we go. So it's models, dark mod, props. Now I think this is the place that you dump the model prop models into as well as their textures. Let me just double check that. Oh, then textures, right. Man, this is complicated. Textures. Oh, it would help if I could spell. Right, there we go. There's all the prop textures, etc. for all the different models. Oh, if you ever need to find a texture for a, if you've got, I don't know if SVN is open access or read-only access is open yet, but this is really handy when I need to go looking for a flipping texture. I just come in here. In fact, I should have gone there for D table, but as you probably saw from the previous video, that you can sometimes, when you can find the name of the texture, you can just click on other textures, start typing the three letters of the texture that you want quickly, and it finds them. Right, so roulette table. So models, dark mod, props, textures, roulette table.jpg. Kind of underscore JPEG. We'll call it just roulette wheel. Job done. Now, roulette table texture. He says, can't type. Yeah, we need that bit. Why isn't it viewing the bloody image? It's going to put these marks across it. No. Yeah. Whatever. Christ. There's one there already. No, that's Commons Wiki again. Them and they're trying to flipping co-op the Creative Commons license. Whatever, Wikipedia. There we go. What's this? No, that's not what I want. And that's too low res, and it's not Creative Commons. In fact, did we ever have roulette in? I know we had it in Thief, so hence the reason for putting it in here. What is Wikimedia Commons? Is that free images? Oh, it is posted underneath that. All right, I take it back then. What the hell is unported? Creative Commons Attribute Share Alike 3 Unported. Well, I know all of our stuff is Creative Commons Share Alike, but I don't know what Attribution Unported is. All right, well, for now, this will have to do. Someone can correct me afterwards. Come on, save image. There we go. I can chop off the roulette part of it, wheel part of it, I should say, afterwards. I'm going to have to cut out the word American roulette off of it. Americans with their appropriating. You know what? I don't think roulette sounds like a French name. Yeah, French physicist. Thank you. Anyway, Those are the textures that we need. All right, let's get back to the mapping. So yeah, roulette wheel or large card playing table. Although that said, I've put card playing on two of these tables. Then I've put backgammon on one and chess on the other. So you could have the roulette thing would be a nice. Also, I've asked Spring Hill if he can make the on the first floor. You know those. Where are we? That one, but without the chain, and there's so basically the chain and that bottom model separate, because at the moment if I place that model in here, the chain pokes up through the floor. We can't be having that. In fact, no, I can change the texture of these to the red version to distinguish the room. All right, I'm gonna have to chop the edge of that off. Now these brushes seal the upper and lower floors. So as I'm chopping them up, it chops them up here as well. But if you wanted to, you could always slice those down the middle, and then it allows you to chop them up separately per light level. But on a small map like this, it's not going to make any difference. But on bigger maps, that's something you have to take into account. I still haven't. I've got to populate the foyer, however you pronounce it. And then the stairs area, I have to populate that as well. I'm thinking of putting, what could we put in there? I don't know, I envisage a fireplace just there, because that hallway would get a bit chilly. Although I could put a fireplace there as well. In fact, you know what? That's what I'm going to do. It's part of the population process for the foyer. Man, I need to know how to pronounce things. Foyer. Come on. Foyer. So. Where's the pronunciation? There we go. I don't know what those words are supposed to be, because that second one isn't a flipping letter. There we go. All right, it's British English.
Foyer.
Foyer. That sounds very French. How does the American say it?
Foyer.
Okay, there we go. There's your problem. Two different languages pronouncing the same word. Although it does sound like a French word. So I would go with the French word, the French pronunciation. Right, fireplace. So that gives that room a bit of warmth. And obviously the kitchen gets its warmth from the flipping giant hunk of metal that is the stove. I'm thinking a sofa along there. Some statues in the corner. I don't know. I'll come up with something. In fact, let's just see what a fireplace looks like in the stairs area. Too many fireplaces? Yeah, I think too many fireplaces. We won't have one there. I don't know what I'm going to stick there. Probably some paintings and things. Yeah, this room and that room could probably do with some paintings. Oh yeah, look, you can really see the dirt patches now on those lamps. It's looking like a proper tavern almost. In fact, those tables look a bit too. Let's get rid of those candles, shall we? What skin are they using? Yeah. Might have to make a skin for this. I really wanted a skin that matches those. Now I think I have a prefab model. I'll need them for now. That'll remind me to do something about it afterwards. Ironically, this is the remember the thing I said about the those stools there not being tall enough. They're perfect for this. Excuse me. Excuse me. Grand. I don't know if we're gonna put a rug down the middle of this thing. Would you have that in a tavern? Let's have a look. I'm gonna move the sizing from it. There we go. Well, it is an in-house tavern, or is it? I don't know enough about this mission. You'd have to let me know. All right, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. As in from the edge of the desk, so 1, 2, 3 and a half, 1, 2, 3, yeah, not quite. There we go. I can have a look at it in game after the fact. In fact, that's a little bit of a twist to it. Grand. I can add some decoration into the corners there after the fact. Or maybe even a half desk, half one of these. Up against the wall. Right, anyway, where were we? Yeah, so now you've seen all of that. Let's seal up the ground floor. Again, I'll chop the holes for the doors after the fact. I'm going to run a three, as you can see, there's a thing at grid three after the fact. Why did I put that wall so up close? Better. That was really mucking around with my OCD. Oh, I know why. It's because of that. These wine racks. Fine, they're just gonna have to stay the way they are then. I move those out a smidge. Nope, they're clipping into it already. Alright, anyway, so back to ceiling. Just go around the outside because we will be placing outside walls. Oh, hang on. That can go to there. Can start the next one there. Do that interior wall in a sec. Right, yeah, those are outside walls done. Right, still our interiors. Ah, good old cloning, especially when the walls are all the same length. There's something cathartic. Cathartic, I don't know if that's the right word, about what we were doing before, like making the walls, you know, drawing them out along the length that we needed. Oh, that doesn't look good. Oh, I think it's all of them. Yep. Hang on, I think I'll draw one along here. If I'm going to seal this little room off. Yeah, I'm definitely going to have to do something about that wall. What could I do? Because it's half the width of one of them. And it's definitely going to poke out past the flipping outside wall by a huge amount. And I can't have it clip into the stairs. So this is going to be one of these ones where it's going to be one thing clip, one. Yeah. Going to be very tight. And then which length am I changing? That one there, is it? To 0.75? Nope, wrong one. So it's probably that one. Yep. But still poking out too far. And the wrong texture. What I want is that texture in there. That I'm going to have to change to a single piece. It's going to have to be two single pieces there. Is that still poking out a bit too far? Yep. Well, let's point that to 0.7 then. Yep, there we go. It's dirty and hopefully the player won't notice. Then there's that one. That doesn't allow me to change it. So the only option I've got is to pull a quick one, which is to do create a patch to go over the top of it. And create two of them. And then just move this one off by grid 0.125. In fact, I'm going to move that in just by a smidge. Go. Does the bottom one line up? It does. Happy days! Right, now we clone one at 0.125 and give it that decal texture. Fit it. Black. Hide that. Hide that floor. Whoa, what the hell is going on there? Oh, it's the ceiling things. Fair enough, that makes sense. Oh, there is no end corridor there, is there? There's just that one. Happy days. Another bug in DR. Oh, that was it. Bugs to thing. Maybe that's what I called that document. Where is it? Yeah. Right, so I've got two documents to fill out. I was getting confused. Layers retain. Retain tick box. Don't, but aren't shown as indicated by the black of blue colour on the button. I should have logged that for DR20 when I was using DR204 and never got around to doing it. So, touch wood, Grebo will get to do it for 205.5 or 206. Right, so are we on the ground floor now? Yes, we are. Right, and I've done that. So now, grid 4 or grid 8, I can just copy that over there. And blam! Now, someone, you can change what that's on them. All I've done is I've shrunk the table down, made it non-solid. Well, let me just check that I've done that. I did. And then just place the brush around it. So collision still works correctly. But you could probably change that to a normal vase instead of a loot vase, because there's probably too much loot in this mission as it is. Right, what did I say I was going to do? Oh, we're missing some interior ceiling. Or are we? Hang on. Oh yeah, we are missing. Hang on, no, I did that. So where has that gone? Fucking hell. I know for a fact I did that wall. You saw me doing it, so where the hell is it gone? Let's close down DR and go back into it. Fuck's sake. Yeah, there it is. The fuck? Maybe did I hide it? I'll have to look back through the video. Right, I'm going to go and watch some more designated survivor, and I'll wait for your feedback on this video.